But we will now look in the example on the web search engines, why it is nevertheless interesting to work with approximations of matrices, in particular in cases where the original matrix is so large that it is very difficult to handle it numerically. So for us to understand this example, we first have to get an understanding on how we can perform search on a document, for example. So we will learn how to create a web search engine when we use a vector space model. And central for this discussion to follow are the term-by-term document matrices. A term-by-document matrix A is constructed that by letting the entries A, I, J represent the frequency of a certain word, I, in the document J. We are interested in the situation when a document, for example, are web pages, but this can be, of course, applied to other documents as well. So on the right-hand side, we see such a matrix. We have four documents, and every document has been searched for a certain number of words: advisor, algebra, ball, calculus, club, computer, and math. And the numbers here tell us that the word algebra occurs once in document 1, 0 times in the documents 2 and 3, and once in document 4, while ball only occurs 3 times in document 4 and doesn't occur in the other documents, and so on. So here is again the list of all the terms from each document. And we would now like to search for the word club using this matrix. The row corresponding to club is this row here. So 0, 1, 2, 0. So we find the word club in the document 2 and 3. So this is again here our matrix, and we now create a query vector which contains a 1 for the club row. So when a document does not contain the term club, for example document number 4, then multiplying this column with this vector returns 0, because the query meets a 0 occurrence of the corresponding term. So in other words, club doesn't occur in document number 4. When we take the third document here, club occurs 2 times, so the multiplication returns 2. So when we think of the query vector and the columns of our matrix A as vectors as well, then we can compute an angle between our query vector and the matrix just by using the standard scalar product. So for example here, document number 3 times this is 2, and divided by the norm of the column and the norm of the query vector, so 2 by square root of 5. This is the cosine of the angle between the two vectors. When Q is identical with the J's, with the column of A, the angle between the vector Q and this column of A vanishes, and the cosine of this angle is 1. So the larger value, the value of cosine theta is after the multiplication here, the closer our query vector is to the actual content of the document. So a large value of this cosine suggests that the document may be relevant for our search, in particular for our term by document matrix A and the query vector Q for club. These are the matrices A and the vector Q. And we can now just perform the multiplication with all the column vectors here. And these are the cosines that we find for all four documents. We find 0 for the first and for the last document. Let's go back a moment. So we have no club here and we have no club here. So documents 1 and 4 are irrelevant for our search. And we have these two for our other documents. And this is relevant because think of a case where we don't search only for the word club, but also for other words, so that the query vector contains multiple entries here. So we cannot just look at a single occurrence of the word, but we need to somehow quantify how closely the documents match our search. So in applications of the singular value documentation decomposition to document retrieval, the columns U of the vector U are commonly are referred to as term vectors and the V columns as document vectors. Yeah, so when we ignore the last terms, we can write this down here. So the projection of the scaled document onto a k-dimensional space is given by this. Or similarly, the projection of the scale terms onto a k-dimensional space can be expressed as this. So we project now our search space and the document space into the same vector space to compute angles between the corresponding entries. So this is the singular value decomposition here of our example matrix A. So we find here the three matrices. And when we define EJ as the j's axis vector, so that the jth element is 1, the point E5 transpose times U2 sigma 2 is the projection of the fifth term club, where UJ5 denotes the fifth entry of the vector U. Or similarly for the third term and so on. So the terms are described here by sigma times U and the documents as sigma by V. And multiplying all those into the same space gives us a number of points or vectors here in the U1, U2, or sigma 1, U1, or sigma 2, U2 components. And when we plot those, then we have here the points from the term space and the squares from the document space. So we have a two-dimensional projection of the terms and the documents. we see that the projections of the fifth term, which is club here, and of the third document are very close. This indicates that the third document is likely to be a relevant document when we search for club, or that the first document is relevant when we search for math, or maybe also for algebra. So for example, note that algebra does not appear in document number 2. But this does not mean that the angle between here the algebra vector, so this is the origin, and the document 2 vector have a 90 degree angle so that the cosine actually vanishes. This is somewhat smaller than 90 degree. This indicates that document number 2 may be somewhat relevant to algebra. And that is because the document 2 contains words club, math, and advisor. And document number 4 and doc 1 contain the word math and algebra. So all three documents contain the word math, and therefore the documents may be relevant to this query, even though the explicit term is not in there, but related terms are found in document number 2. So by the projection here into this two-dimensional space, we find relations between documents from their occurrence in the corresponding documents. We also notice that document number 3 does not contain the words math and algebra, which indicates that this document is unrelated to the query. And when we look at the angle between algebra and document 3, it's almost 90 degrees. So this is a nice example, but we also have to consider that literal matching of terms in documents is not always giving us a clear answer. So a better approach is to match a query with the meaning of a document. Latent semantic indexing does just that. It overcomes the problems of lexical matching by using statistically derived quantities instead of individual words for matching. So this latent semantic indexing examines the whole content collection to determine which documents contain similar words. So LSI considers documents that have words in common to be semantically close, and documents with few words in common to be semantically distant. So we can now compute a quantitative distance or similarity figure for documents. So when AK is to be the rank K approximation of A, so working with AK instead of A has some advantages. So we need less memory, we remove unimportant information, the search space is smaller. Given the fact that when we have many documents and many possible words, our matrix A becomes quickly very huge. And at some point, it's only possible to work on approximations, lower dimensional approximations of the matrix A. However, the explicit choice of the value of K is an empiric choice. So we need some experience to actually choose a good rank approximation. But even for large documents, K of 1 might give already acceptable results. So when we work with AK instead of the original matrix A, we can again compute the angles of our query vector with our approximated matrix A, like this, and then find the projections of the query vector and the document vector onto this k-dimensional space. So when we use k equals 2, for our example, we find these angles for our cosines when we are looking for the word clubs, which gives the ordering document number 3, document number 2, 1, and document number 4, where the first one is the most and the last one is the least relevant document. Looking for algebra, we find these cosines with document 1 and 4 being almost equally relevant, and then document 2 and document 3 almost irrelevant. The angles show that document 2 has some connection to algebra. And finally, we also note that weighting of the terms in a term by document matrix, so instead putting in, for example, a 2 or a 3 instead of a 1 in the query vector, can affect the result significantly. Or we can weight the terms in the term by document matrix. This might be relevant because a document that repeats the same word many times will give us a very high ranking in a search when so an erroneously high ranking when we do not weight the occurrence.